Hello, my name is Brandon Harp and I'm the superintendent of Seymour Community Schools. I'd like to welcome all of our returning staff and all of our new staff to the new 23-24 school year. We'll get to our new staff a little bit later in the video as we look forward to introducing them as we typically do at the high school each year. Speaking of the high school, we typically have our all staff return to school meeting each year. This year, because the auditorium is still under construction, we don't really have a place to do that meeting. And then also, we have so many staff members in transition to new spaces throughout the corporation that we thought it'd be a good idea this year to do this via video and allow all of our staff members to maximize their time on the first 2 days of school. So we hope you watch. We hope you'll get the information that you typically get during the opening day through this video. I want to start off by saying, first of all, it's been a crazy summer, a hectic summer with lots of continued construction, and we're going to give you a sneak peek at some of the construction here in a little bit. But our year-round staff has been amazing this summer, trying to fill staffing needs and continuing to get us going into the right direction into these new spaces, which I think you're going to like. We know we're going to have some bumps in the road as we begin the school year. Anytime there's this much change, you know that there are going to be some bumps. We're prepared for that, and we're going to work together to get through each of those bumps. So those year-round employees have done a great job. Even our non-year-round employees, I've seen so many teachers in the buildings this summer, you know, just working ahead of time. I'm always thankful for having such a professional staff who's out there working with us, getting us ready to go. So again, a little later in the video, we're going to introduce all the new staff, and we're going to give you a little bit of a sneak peek into all this construction. To kind of close up right now, I want to thank our school board. They've worked tirelessly on these projects and a few other things. You know, they do a lot more than just attend a board meeting on the first Tuesday of every month. We have a really good board. I really appreciate them. And speaking of our board president, Art Juergens, wants to take a few minutes to address you as we get going on the new school year. So thanks again for checking in, and go Owls.
Good morning. My name is Art Juergens. I'm president of the school board. And I want to welcome everyone back for the 23-24 school year. Hope you had some time to spend with your family and get relaxed and ready to go. And I enjoy this day. It's unfortunate we can't go to the auditorium, but we'll put it on the virtual, and you can look at it there. Okay, last couple of days I've been visiting the schools. I'm going to try to get to all of them before we start. I went to the high school yesterday, middle school the other day, and intermediate school. Just, I didn't know what to say. It was just unbelievable what those schools look like. And later on down the line, we'll try to get everybody through them so they can look at it. The only thing is, there is construction. You'll just have to bear with that. And in a few months, everything will be done and we can continue on. Now, we have a 7-member school board. And the following are on the board: Kenny Browning, John Kelly, Holly Coates, Joe Tormel, Max Klosterman, Ryan Chandler, and myself. So it's been a 7-member board as long as I can remember. The thing about our board is we work together. We're not against each other. You read about some school boards that fighting among themselves, and that's not good for your school system or your community. The board's job is to make policy, and that's our job, and that's what we do. We do not micromanage. We haven't done that since I've been on the school board. And the reason we do that, we hire good qualified people to run the everyday system, the operations of the school system. So if you got a good person in a position, then things are going to run well. I've had very, very few complaints, very, very few phone calls, because everything has run pretty well. well. Okay? No matter what your position in the school system is, you're a valuable asset. We're all together, and we want to keep it that way and, you know, work for Seymour Community Schools. I'd like to welcome all new employees this year. We hope you enjoy your time at Seymour. Another thing is we continue to have students come back from college that choose to return to work in our system. So that's good. We know these kids, and they bring a lot back to the school system. I want to thank everyone at the Ad Building. The Ad Building keeps our school running through the summer, through the year. I want to thank the three superintendents, Mr. Hart, Mrs. Ferguson, and Mr. Reese here. They worked hard this year to get everything ready for our school year. Again, the construction, you just have to kind of take that as we go. Each month you'll see less and less, and finally it will be done. A couple comments. If you should work with your principal, go through your principal if you have any problems or you have any questions. That's your person that you go to. And they will help you out. We've got a lot of good principals, and they will, you know, answer your questions and so on. Be careful with social media. We don't want you to put something on there that could harm you. And we've had it in the past, a few instances. So if you stay away from that, I think that would help your career. Facilities, you have some of the finest facilities in the state of Indiana. I really believe our school system is one of the best. Well, it might be the best in Southern Indiana, best in the state of Indiana. We have bargaining schedule, and we'll work with that at the end of August. We've been very successful with that. Few short meetings. It wasn't like it used to be where it was drag out. So we'll be getting in touch with the teachers and everyone concerning bargaining. I just want to give you a couple of trends in education and then end up. We have a shortage of about 3,000 teachers in Indiana. Can't find them. The colleges are not putting the people out. People aren't going into teaching. There are some high schools that have what they call a teacher apprentice program, and they're training these kids to become teachers and go to college, and a lot of them will probably come back to their school system. I realize that the duties keep growing for educators, and I think a lot of that is from the legislatures. You know, if it just lets you teach and take care of your kids, it would be much better. Safety, big believer in safety. We put a great safety schedule together. We got resource officers, they're all trained. We've got very good security system. Think one thing about Seymour Community Schools, we try to solve the problems before they become a major problem or something that, you know, we can't handle. And the SROs do a great job. So we've spent millions of dollars on safety. Cameras, doors, and everything like that. So I think you're in a safe environment. If you see something, though, tell your principal, and we'll try to correct that. As a former teacher, I taught 37 years and coached, and I realize the job that is put in front of you. So I know sometimes you get frustrated, but you just got to work through it. Go to your colleagues. They'll help you out. I'd like to leave you with two thoughts. Most effective teachers are not the ones that know, but the ones that care the most. And we have an organized structure that every child feels safe, connected, and valued by our staff. And our programs accommodate diversity groups of learning. I want to wish you good luck this year. Just a little bit about my health. I was cancer-free in June. That's 4 years. So I still struggle a little bit, but I love this job, and I love Seymour Community Schools. So I look forward to your working with you. Good luck this year.
Okay, we're on the campus of Seymour High School with Mr. Prangy. The question I get the most when I'm out in the community is, how is the new construction going? What are the new procedures? And we thought this would be a great opportunity for our staff to get an inside look at some of our new construction areas. You know, if I'm getting those questions, I assume a lot of you are getting those questions, and we want to make sure that you're able to answer those questions. So Mr. Prangy, longtime principal of Seymour High School, he's going to start us off and take us through the new front entrance and the procedures to check into the school. And it's also interesting to add, the address of Seymour High School has always been 1350 West 2nd Street. However, most of you know, you've always entered off of Community Drive. Well, now that's changed.
I'll tell you what, it's been one of the biggest things for the community that I've given tours to, that now we're all of a sudden we're finally on 2nd Street. But welcome to Seymour High School, all of Seymour High School community staff. We're going to walk in the main entrance here. This is where visitors come when they have appointments with administrators, with counselors, or they just have questions. We can walk you through that and show you how we get people into our new office area. We're now in the new foyer, and this is where people will enter when they visit Seymour High School. They'll come to this window, they will be greeted by our friendly staff, and we'll answer questions. This is a starting point for anybody who wants to see counselors, wants to see administrators, has any questions about the nurse or teachers, anything like that. We start here. This is our focal point, and then we spread out from here. They will contact us. Most people have appointments when they come. However, regardless of how they get here, this is where the action starts in Seymour High School.
And Mr. Prangy, we take a lot of pride in our secure front doors at our school, and this one's no different, right? We have a secure vestibule here.
We have several layers of security in this office alone. It takes electronic access to get into student services and then into the main building as well. And that's all controlled through this office right here. So very secure.
Speaking of secure.
Yeah, okay. There we go. And we're in. We're now in the main vestibule where we would head on to classes. This is where students can come in to see student services or to see Sanja if she has any kind of a message for them or entrance or needs to get into our main office, which is just located down here by the off of her office. So student services and the main office, the administration, is now combined basically under one area.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Prangy, for showing us the new front entrance. I'll let you get back to your day, and I'd like to continue with the tour and show one of the spaces I'm really excited about, and that's the new cafeteria.
Let's go.
Have a great day.
Thank you.
Here we go. So as you can see, we're in a new corridor, and we were out of locker space at Seymour High School, so we're excited to have all these new lockers in purple, not green like they used to be. But also, the corridor itself is so important. If you've ever walked down the hallways during a passing period at Seymour High School, I mean, it is crowded, it is congested, and we have this corridor and a couple others that are going to help relieve some of that congestion. So let's go take a look at the end of the hallway toward the cafeteria space. And here's Mr. Bush, assistant principal. How are you today?
What's up, Mr. Harp? Welcome to SCSC Cribs. Come on down, let's check out where the magic happens in the cafeteria.
You might be able to give us some additional information that maybe I couldn't on the cafeteria here. So if you wouldn't mind joining us.
Absolutely. This cafeteria, it's already in use. Our band camp's going on this week as we're filming. A little bit delayed in our release, but band camp last day. You'll see the color guard taking advantage of this great space, big, wide, large corridor with seating for over 600 kids.
What are the plans for room 100?
Room 100 is a large group community space. We'll use it for staff meetings. We'll use it for testing. We'll use it for teachers can combine classrooms and utilize this great space.
Is it open for us to take a quick peek?
It is. It's set up for freshman orientation right now, kind of a theater seating style. Come on in and check it out.
Sure. So Mr. Bush, I envision, you said it's set up for freshman orientation. I envision this being a space that we can use for different kinds of staff meetings, safety meetings, even community meetings. I mean, this is something that our school has lacked for a long time.
Yes, yep, and we have the nesting furniture similar to what you guys will have over at the admin building, and we can do a variety of things and stage it in a variety of ways. We're excited about it.
And I think back to when I was at the high school, we were always looking for places for Key Club and student government and things like that to meet. I think now we have suitable spaces for that, so that's exciting.
Yes, this will be hot during SRT. Yeah. So as we said, we're set up for band camp right now. It'll look a little different, but as you enter our bus lobby here, it opens up to a breakfast bar on the far right over here. And then we have 5 different serving stations this year to offer all kinds of varieties to our students. We're really excited about that. State-of-the-art seating, from booth seating to high-top seating. And then the video wall is coming together right now. It's being installed as we speak, and we are really excited about that feature. Special thanks to our tech department for making that happen for us.
And so, Mr. Bush, what about this space, this entry exit point right here?
All right. So, many of you are familiar with our old bus lobby, right through that door here. Our new bus lobby, right through here. All bus drop-off will take place right here, and we're really excited to have a sheltered area for our students to wait on buses.
And as we've talked about quite a bit, we have done a lot of work in this corporation in the last few years on branding, and that doesn't stop with our cafeteria furniture. Can we take a look at some of our new furniture, our branded furniture?
Absolutely. Decals are coming on the walls, and wall graphics are coming between the time this is filmed and the students arrive. But we worked with some local vendors on some really awesome branding on our booth seating and our high top tables and our custom chairs that are made, and it just really pulls this space together. It's you can feel the owl pride in here, no matter
where
you are.
And it's not set up as it's going to be, because obviously we're using it for some band camp stuff, but I just love the variety, the different types of flexible seating that we have and that sort of thing. So
the feedback from the students at band camp is that this place is absolutely amazing, and we can't wait to show it to all of our kids.
Okay, great. Thanks for taking a few minutes with us. I want to do one more stop on the trip. Let's go down and take a look at some of the areas that are still under construction. So I was walking down to show you some of the new construction. I ran into Mrs. Boley, assistant principal at the high school, and she's agreed to help us out and kind of point out some of the new things. So the first thing that I noticed, Mrs. Boley, is this is where we used to come in off of Community Drive, and we used to walk straight through the cafeteria. What's going on now?
Well, as you can see, we are talking about that safety piece and just the shift in the building. This was door one. Now all of this is closed in. This used to be the cafeteria, and we've changed things up a little bit. Construction will continue through the school year, but this will be the entrance to the new fine arts area. We've got the band room and the choir that will be there. And here we have new classrooms that will be for EL and state-of-the-art facts labs that will take place for our family and consumer sciences. And then we are connecting, for the first time ever, the gym to the main building. So there will be a new breezeway, secure transition area for our students to go from the gym to the building.
So now we're in the area that used to be the kitchen, not the seating area, but the work area. What's this going to be like?
It'll be new equipment in the old kitchen area that'll put together for the facts labs. So
that,
existing space, new equipment.
Yeah, that's great. Mm-hmm. Able to use the old power drops and all that kind of stuff. So that seemed like a natural transition for our facts classes. So this is going to be a great new space.
Yeah.
And our last stop on the new construction tour in this area. So this is outside of the auditorium. Used to be an awning here, used to be a walk-up, and then the gym is to our north. So what's going on here?
Yeah, this is all new square footage that we've been able to add. We've done a lot of conversion of old square footage, like in the facts area. Now we're adding new square footage. This is going to be the new fine arts area for the band and the choir. Our band is massive, and we have a very strong choir department as well. Our old facilities worked, but we just outgrown that capacity, and so now we have new state-of-the-art areas for them that'll be appropriate for the acoustics and to really help grow those programs. So this is all, the band will be here and the choir will be there.
It's always funny, you know, our fine arts programs continue to attract mm-hmm. students to Seymour High School, and I'm sure it's going to continue with great spaces like this. And the last thing I'll say is over toward the gym, we're now being connected,
yeah.
And what's going on there?
Yeah, that'll be the breezeway that'll be connecting us to the main building. We have students who transition over there for classes, for gym. We have a couple of classroom spaces over yeah. there for health, and so they will be able to transition enclosed, and again, back to that safety feature of getting kids in and out of different spaces here without having to go outside.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, yeah. Mrs. Boley, for the tour. This yeah. has been helpful, and
Thanks.
Hope our people appreciate that. And I hope to be able to do this again when we get a little closer to having this space completed.
Yeah, it's been great.
Okay, so this concludes our tour of the new SHS construction. I want to send it over to the southeast to Mrs. Ferguson at Seymour Intermediate.
You're going to notice a lot of things have changed around Seymour School since you all left in May, but there are some things that we build into everything we do. Let's go see what they are.
We are student-centered. Students needing support in the area of life skills will be able to engage with hands-on curricula, such as cooking and laundry, in a space that is suited for their individual academic and social-emotional needs.
We are student-centered. Our classrooms offer learning environments to meet all of our students' needs. With one-to-one devices for our students and state-of-the-art technology, we are able to get our students ready for the real world.
We offer limitless opportunities for our students. Introducing our brand new cutting-edge music space, where creativity and harmony come together.
We have brand new restrooms to accommodate our growing population at Seymour Intermediate. We have three brand new restrooms that we are excited for students to be able to utilize during the school day.
Relationships built here last a lifetime. Seymour Community Schools strive to provide a climate and culture conducive to excellence every day.
Our vibrant new spaces provide a warm, inviting, safe environment for all of our students.
Soaring to excellence, everyone, every day.
We create great spaces for kids to fuel up with nutritious food so they're ready for their best academic performance to learn and grow. And now I'm going to kick it over to Talmadge Reisner at the Seymour Ag Science Center.
All right, for the last stop of our field trip today, I want to introduce some of you, maybe for the very first time, to our Ag Science Center. It's an area that we're really proud about. In fact, we're truly unique. Not very many school systems have a facility such as this to be able to offer what we're able to offer. And in Seymour Community Schools, we really pride ourselves on making certain that students have opportunities. And that is really focused on what they're going to do beyond high school. For some, that's going to be all the educational opportunities they have to prepare themselves for college. For others, it's going to be able to prepare them for the workforce and possibly for a career in the military. So at the Seymour Ag Science and Research Center, obviously it's focused on ag. It's located on a 110-acre working farm that we have here in Freeman Field in Industrial Park. We also now offer welding as well as precision machining. And those are two programs that have expanded quite a bit in the last few years. So why don't you join me? I'm going to take you on a quick tour and kind of share with you a little bit more about what we offer. Once you enter into the Ag Science Center, you're going to be greeted by Mrs. Stuckwish, who is the Director of Secondary Special Programs. And what we've learned is not one size fits all. There's many students who, even 10 years ago, you went to the high school, you stayed there all day, every day for all of your courses. And that just doesn't work for some students. It doesn't meet their needs or it doesn't engage them in their interests. And so as we've expanded into this program, we've taking things like the Ag Science Center and the programs that it offers. We also have an online academy called AlTech. We also have an alternative school called Jackson County Learning Center. And for a variety of reasons, kids can kind of pick and choose their own pathway, and that's what we want to be all about. So again, I'm going to take you a little bit further in, and we kind of look at some of the ag offerings that we have. In agriculture, we have your typical plant and soil sciences and your food sciences and animal sciences. But we also have agribusiness, ag management. We also have a landscape opportunity for children that are interested in maybe starting their own landscaping company. We do work throughout the community. It's a really great opportunity. We have three full-time instructors as well as a half-time instructor in our ag program, which makes it, again, one of the largest in the state, and we're really proud of that, particularly to kind of showcase all of the ag opportunities we have here in Jackson County. One of our more recent additions is the welding program that we started 3 years ago, and that program has grown from initially 12 students with an instructor that we shared with Ivy Tech to now having our own full-time instructor and a max capacity of 88 with students even on the waiting list. Also unique about this program, and one of the others I'll show you, is that we partner with local schools. If we have an opening in our program, we allow other neighboring schools to join these courses on a tuition fee basis, and we have students that do that in this welding class as well as in our precision machining class. So I'll take you on inside and give you a peek into what our labs look like. So when we first began, this was the welding lab, and as you can see, it's all three processes. It is stick, MIG, and TIG, as well as a little bit of acetylene torch cutting. But it's 10 bays. Those are multi-process welders, and we have students in here every day, all day, working on that welding certification. Probably the most satisfying part about programs such as these is at the end of their year, typically we host interview sessions with many of our local employers, and most of these students walk out with job offers straight out of high school. And so we're really, really proud of the work that they are able to produce to be able to parlay that into an employment opportunity. With the rapid growth of our program, we quickly saw a need to be able to expand the workspaces for the students. And so 2 years ago, we added these additional 12 booths, and we filled those very, very quickly. And so again, we saw a need. We utilized our resources that were around us, and were able to create a great opportunity for them. And so again, this is just one more aspect of being able to help kids maximize the potential and utilize the opportunities that are before them. As the demand for these courses began to rise at the high school, we saw a need to be able to expand this facility, which is incredible in itself. It was first opened in 2017, and we broke ground to expand it almost double in size in 2021. So again, saw a need, utilized our resources to be able to create opportunities for kids. Where we're standing now is a precision machining lab. It's fully functional. This is something that the local industry has said that they need, and we've seen demand within the students that they would like to be able to participate in those things. The greatest change you're going to see in the next few years just within this program is the automation and the robotics side, as well as the digital side to many of these tools. So for every one of these, what we would consider manual tools, you will see a digital component that will begin doing the work, and the students will be able to have that opportunity to learn how to utilize current technology in the precision machining field. This is our food science lab. We offer several courses on the agricultural side, but also on the family and consumer sciences side. And in these spaces, students are learning really about farm to table. We typically are taking food literally from the fields that we farm. We are processing that food. We're learning about the components of what makes a nutritious meal, and then we're designing meals that are associated with that. So again, we're really, really excited about the things that students are able to do and how each of the different student interest groups come together to create one product that all of us can enjoy. So again, very, very proud of this space. And in keeping with our construction theme, I want to showcase our newest structure at the Ag Science Center, and that's our new greenhouse. It's a truly state-of-the-art facility that we can't wait to get into and let our students be able to enjoy. It has all kinds of different features that are going to allow them to explore what it would be like to grow and maintain fruits, vegetables, and plants, as well as an aquaponics area. Thank you for joining us at the Ag Science Center, and I want to kick it back to Mr. Harp at Corporate Way.
One of the other traditions we have at our opening meeting every year is we like to introduce our new staff, and we're going to do that next via video. And I think you'll like the new feature we've added to the video. You get a little bit more information about each of the prospective new employees. So welcome aboard to all of our new staff. We're glad to have you. Here they are. For the last part of the video, I'm joined today by Corey Robinson. Corey's a 2023 Seymour High School graduate, so he just walked across the stage in May. He is attending Purdue this fall, and he has decided to continue his career in the field of education. Corey has agreed to join us here today and give the closing remarks for the video. So Corey, thanks for joining us today, and I'm going to turn it over to you.
Thank you. Yeah, I just want to start off my video by thanking all the people who affected me in such a positive way. Even though it may not have seemed like some days I would come to school down, unmotivated, and it never ceased to amaze me, the smile that was on my face by the end of my first period class. My teachers, even though they have bills to pay, kids, and all their lively struggles, it was amazing that how they lightened up my day and solved all my problems with just a smile. So, as you guys go into your next school year, continue to be you, continue to be the great teachers you are, and I wish you the best 2023-2024 school year. Go Owls!